all of the camera work for in game at least for Riot. So he, you know, he did it for PAX and he's done it for IPL events and done it for season 2 championships. So he's actually subbing in. You know, that's gonna be kind of cool. They're gonna use the Riot cheat codes.
Yeah,
but
definitely.
This is the first guy I've ever seen with great teammate. Everyone always gets honorable opponent because you play well, and when you lose, your opponents go, "Oh, that sucks. You lost. Here's, you know, have
honor.
A cookie." So, yeah. Great teammate. I haven't seen that before. That's cool. But yeah, he's going to be playing. Wild Turtle's also playing, but and he had actually just joined the team recently.
Yeah.
Gosu Zuna though, coming in for Fear, is also an interesting one. You know, they still haven't decided what's going on with their top lane. So. You know, I don't know if they would maybe poach him from CLG Black. He's still in CLG Black, but Ghost Zuna at the very least is subbing right now for Fear.
Interesting. But you're seeing a lot of the bans come in, and a lot of these champs are very powerful on the Crystal Scar. Rengar is huge because there's so many bushes. Jace has great control. Diana, Jax, Ezreal, all super mobile. And really, when it comes to minion, mobility is absolutely key. You want to make sure you can get from point to point with very little trouble. Kog'Maw is a strange ban, actually, in this kind of setup, but there are a lot of huge champs that are open. Rammus is open. Kassadin is open. Pantheon was open, and he's been taken, and actually going for the Kha'Zix, which is an interesting pick here.
Yeah, Kha'Zix, I have to imagine, is really strong. I mean, his leap is really good. I think we've seen him a little bit in the past, so that's going to be cool. Pantheon, you know, his global is really nice, and then also the poke he has with his spears is really strong as well. And Katarina, you know, we've seen her in the past, so pretty common. But there's a couple of unusual champions that we're missing here. And if you look at the key, like, if you were to ask who are the strongest champions in Dominion that you have to see in every single match, some of the key guys that would come up every single time are Rammus, Shaco, Blitzcrank, in particular. Yep. I mean, there's a couple of others,
Kassadin's up there. Jace is definitely up.
Right.
Well, Jace is overpowered in
every... Jace is definitely overpowered, but he's banned.
Yeah.
I'm saying these are champions that you usually expect to see, and they're not being picked or banned.
Right.
So that's kind of an interesting thing.
I'm still waiting on the Soraka, though, because we've seen Soraka in the past down in that bot lane, an absolute tank. You cannot be moved once you start maxing out that star call. Your magic resist goes negative, and you're just having a bad time.
Was that Muffin Cutie versus Saint Vicious as the Soraka?
Yes. Yes, it was, actually, because I remember Saint Vicious went Mundo.
Yeah.
And he was abusing the lane for, like, the first 5 minutes. But then the levels started kicking in. Then the star call started happening, and then just rained upon down on to the Mundo, and it was just a bad time from there on in. It was a rough start. Don't get me wrong, it was a very rough start.
Oh, Lee Sin's really strong. Every match we see with Lee Sin on Dominion, he seems to be able to win with his mobility, his quick burst damage. He just dives in and out for kills, so that's going to be brutal. And we saw the last game, you know, how strong Lee Sin was when Hai was playing him.
Going to be considering the Shen also here on Team Fear, which is a little bit of an odd pick, but it's good. It's going to keep that mobility up. You have champs like Yi and Kha'Zix who are very mobile. They have that speed. They have those leaps. And have Shen actually join in on you for those. You know what? This actually looks... Fear may actually be going for a straight-out, like, tower-diving team.
Oh, there's the Blitzcrank.
There's the Blitzcrank. There's a... You usually only ever see, like, one garrison, if that, and it's usually for the bottom lane. The fact that Fear right now is actually going for two, and what appears to be not champs that won't be going bottom, that's very interesting to see.
Yeah, they're still, you know, going to swap, but we'll see. And it is cool to see two garrisons. I'm curious. I wanted to see the TF, Wild Turtle. You know, we'd seen his TF in the past, so that would be fun to see. But, I don't know, we'll see what both of these guys are picking. I don't know, really, you can just pick whatever you like. You know, all the champions, there's so much champion flexibility on Dominion. You know, it's really an open kind of book, so it's going to be cool to see what both these teams can do. But they have to be concerned right now. I'm assuming it's going to be an APE. He's going to have great poke. He's going to be very tanky. Mm-hmm. They have great, like, mobility. They can dive in, pick up a kill. Like, Yi, Kha'Zix, and Lee Sin, they can all dive in, pick up a kill, and get out very easily. Blitzcrank, he can help them, you know, pick up a kill really quickly. So to deal with that, I feel like Nick Allen is better than Red Baron. Needs a team that can either force an initiation and not let you you leave, like just, you know, CC you to death, or has poke. And right now you see Alistar and, you know, Draven, they have enough CC and, you know, pulling potential that they're like, all right, we have you, you're going to die. Whereas the rest of the team has a little bit of poke and burst damage. So it's a nice mix on the
team. But the thing is, though, when you look at a champ like Victor screams poke.
Yeah.
That laser is quite possibly one of the best pokes in the game, and the range on it is such where you can get a defender on any tower.
I'm curious if they ever fix the invisibility bug for Victor, because that's annoying, though. We may see that. And that actually, it does factor into how strong he is.
It does.
Whether or not you can see it.
And also, I cannot wait to see that Pantheon play. Katarina is just going to be diving in pretty much every single day. These are actually both two really big dive-oriented teams. Actually, and I really hope that Wild Turtle takes that revive, because revive on Dominion is damn near necessary the way the minimap has actually flowed. Because if you absolutely 100% need a defender right now, except no substitute. Now, Nidalee going to be the last pick up here over on Team Fear, and it looks like there's not going to be a whole lot of switching going on, but it could actually be Wild Turtle down bot. And Alistar down bot, AP Alistar, that's quite a bit of damage in his own.
Oh, man, I hope it's an AP Alistar. It could also be AD. You can actually, there's different tricks you can do with Alistar where you get in auto attacks while you're in midair with the headbutt pulverize combo, and it allows you to get in more damage as AD Alistar. But like you were saying, the revive, it is basically necessary, and the big reason for it is if you lose a fight when you have the revive up, you lose the fight, they get your turret, you revive, you come back, and you just womp them. You know, take the turret back, you kill them, and you're in a strong position for a little bit.
Right.
If you win a fight and you still have revive up, then you can just bully people around, because then the next fight you win, you're still going to be able to come back. If you don't have that revive, then it's a full, you know, 30 seconds or something like that. You have the long respawn timer, and I don't know, what your summoners are already down because you were just in a fight, so it's an interesting situation. So revive, we have seen in the past, the team that has if one of the teams doesn't take revive, then they've consistently lost. Wild Turtle, he doesn't have it, but he should be okay still, and I'm going to guess it's going to be AD. Let me see. Physical damage, it is AD Alistar.
AD Alistar.
I guessed it right. Move and speed. So AP Alistar is a lot of fun, but AD Alistar has a little bit more sustained damage.
Yeah.
AP Alistar is a little bit more burst, so 9, 15, and 6. If you want to run AD Alistar, there's your guide right there. Moving speed, some physical damage.
Yeah. Anyway, Alistar, he should be fine without the revive, provided he's not bot, because bot lane here in Dominion is the most critical one to have the revive, and a garrison too if you can afford it, because it's the quickest lane to get to from spawn. And odds are, if you're going to be needing that revive, you want to give you're probably in a bad situation already, which means that you're critical. Your team's in a bad spot when your bot tower is being captured on a regular basis, because it's one of the furthest ones away from enemy spawn, and that's how far they are encroaching on your territory. So we'll see. I don't know. We'll see. But a big part of Dominion, though, is that first initial fight when everyone is racing up to 12 o'clock, and we will see how these teams come to play. Who do you think actually has the better? Well, it's not a level one fight. So Dominion. Who here has a better level three?
Team Fear. You know, they have the Blitzcrank pick. They have Lee Sin. Blitzcrank and Lee Sin, every single time we've seen them so far in Dominion, they're able to win the level one fight. They're just so incredibly strong. It's an AD Nidalee, actually, and that's going to be an interesting thing. I'm guessing that it might be AD Nidalee bot, but like you said, Garrison is pretty common for that bottom lane. So you're right. It might be AP Yi, and AP Yi would be, you know, very strong as well. So we'll kind of see what's going on there.
If I had to take a guess, I would say Nidalee.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Because Yi is AP Yi especially is too vital for capturing these points, because you're gonna have a lot of this is
he
a very
the
these
heal,
are both very dive oriented teams like we've talked about before, but the critical part about Yi is the Alpha Strike. You do become untargetable, which is huge, especially when you got a tower just beaten down on you relentlessly. So I can't see any reason why Muffin Cutie actually would not be top.
Yeah, no, he will provide a lot for his team. He gives them AoE damage so they can pick up kills a little bit more easily. It allows Kha'Zix to, you know, try and snowball the fights, and will be pretty interesting. So we'll see what they can do. Blitzcrank, he's going to have a quick movement speed advantage that it's going to allow him to get to the top first. He should be the first one to the top unless they send him to the side capture point. Usually you'll send Blitzcrank to the top so that you can just take the quick double point at the very beginning. But we'll see what they do. nothing that unusual as far as masteries or anything. A couple of interesting runes, but definitely some cool teams. Nidalee has some decent poke. She has the heals for her team. You know, she's going to be kind of a menace. She's not going to have quite as much damage for poke as AP Nidalee would, but she still is going to be able to get people off of those turrets and defend some capture points pretty easily.
Yep. So we should be loading on into this. We should be getting in here just shortly.
The mobility of Nidalee, too, is going to be really strong.
The mobility of Nidalee is going to be... It's an issue anywhere, really. It's an issue in Summoner's Rift. It's an issue on Treeline. It can even be an issue on Proving Grounds, even. And we've actually been seeing a lot of Nidalee when we've done these matches on Murder Bridge. She's like Nidalee and Jace are, like, required on Murder Bridge if you're ever given the opportunity to do
blind pick. Every single game we've seen has basically Nidalee, Jace, and Lux on both teams.
Yes. It's quite silly. We may have actually both these teams decide to go on for the full random. I don't know. We'll see once we get there. We got to get through this one first. We also got guest star Riot Lakaeus actually hopping up here onto the X Orbit team just for funsies. A lot of the former Orb is now off at other events. So they need to fill up some spots. And good on him. You know, give him the thank you for stepping on in and helping give us a show.
Yeah, definitely excited to see how he does.
8 ping, too strong, man.
Oh my gosh, he's like sitting by the server room.
The ping does not get any lower.
Actually, I've
than
seen
that.
0 ping before, but that's like you feel like they must be living across the street, and that doesn't even make sense. I think it might be a glitch.
It's got to be a glitch because 8 ping is what you get at the Riot office.
Yeah, no, yeah, you see it right there. He has 8 ping.
Yeah, so here we are.
Yeah, really cool. And it wouldn't make sense to have 0, but I'm saying it is interesting.
Yeah.
And we'll be able to see what both of these teams
are. Just got to adjust that HUD to make sure we can actually read it this time around. Bring it on back. We're good. It's good enough. We can read it.
Is it? Okay.
Yeah, we're good. So here we are. We've got the setup time for both of these teams. Let's see what everyone's buying. See how much the prospector's going to be in business here. We got a ring. We got a blade. We got some level 2 boots being bought up there by the Blitz. He needs that extra mobility. You got Pantheon. Does not have enough to, you know, he cannot get the Brutalizer straight away as much as he'd like to, but he needs those boots. He will be getting that in his next batch. Just going to have those long swords there in the back end whenever he gets that money.
And going over the levels real quick, Nidalee went with 2 levels in the spear. Yi went with 2 levels in the Alpha Strike. So
yes.
Both of the champions that want the damage. Everyone else is going with the 2 levels in the Death Ray on Victor. So the champions that really need the early damage, you kind of expect it. Everyone else, it seems, is going with an even level distribution. And actually, Darius and Katarina, neither of them have leveled yet. So we'll kind of see.
Oh, Darius is actually going for that Brutalizer, too. That's going to be very interesting. Katarina getting a chain vest and a cloth armor. What the hell? If anything is talking about tower dives, that's really it to me. And we're actually going to be seeing Victor.
Last guy to not level anything.
Victor actually going to be going down to the bot lane here for the former Orb. And actually, you're right. No, it is actually going to be the Yi down bot. So just AP on AP battle down there. And otherwise, it is a race. It is a chase getting to the top. And nice pull. Nice hook onto McSmithy. But everyone's going to be stuck in the middle of everybody. Wild Turtle with the Pulverize getting pretty much all of fear on that one. McSmithy is low. Kha'Zix, can you get out? Yes, you will. But Bounce in the middle, getting those Q, getting the damage and more bleeding out. But Katarina going to be the first one to get a kill. Down onto at least
so close.
Very close. Could nearly get a triple on that just on her own. There's also with
the
cure.
The double.
There's a double down onto the Nidalee. Avrimu was caught out, punched to the face. Katarina going to be going down, but that is World Tour with the follow-up and the double for himself. This is a really good start for the former Orb.
Yeah, they're off to a really Fear just absolutely getting decimated in that previous fight.
Wow, this is huge.
They tried to get in and, I don't know, they were just a little bit too aggressive. Instead of wearing down their opponents, being really slow, poking them, you know, getting Lee Sin in and out. High, very close to going down. He has to back off. McSmithy picks up the kill, and now they're actually going to be able to chase back into them and try and see what they can get. Wild Turtle drops as well. Call Me Pounce is the last guy here. He's going to drop as well. So the turnaround for Fear, they didn't even have to use their revives, so they're able to get back in there. Still, it was a great start for a Team X Orb, and they're still going to be able to come and defend the top capture point.
I'm liking this Victor pick, but that's the problem, though, is that
he's already crushing
it,
though.
He is pretty much out of mana at this point.
Yeah.
He can only sustain down bot for such a long, you know, not enough of a time that he needs to. He's just going to keep that pressure up. Shift Rider getting very close to death.
Body block.
Waiting for it. No missile will not be landing there, but they have both been targeted by the Kha'Zix. So if he manages to hit one of them, that will be quite a bit of extra damage.
Oh.
But Heil 9, though, doing great on the defense here at 12 o'clock, but killing just enough time for a Wild Turtle and Pounce to get back in. There's Mandatory Cloud. He's got his target. He wants the Katarina. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to get it. Yes, he will. You got Kha'Zix going down along with the Nidalee, though. Former Orb, X Orb, still keeping their lead up here at the 12 o'clock point.
Well, they have Aphromoo completely zoned. He's going to go down most likely pretty shortly. Pantheon still trying to chase down Mandatory Cloud. He's going to be able to get the health spot, and I'm surprised they actually haven't killed Aphromoo yet. He's getting that movement speed. He's able to get out of there, so they will be able to hold on to that top capture. They're actually going for the right capture as well, but Muffin Cutie just constantly wearing it right like Hayes. And I think Blitzcrank, he's still running Aphromoo. Call me Pounce has just been chasing him forever.
That's a little absurd, but hey, he's managed to avoid death this long. You might as well reward him in. And actually, here comes Blitz. He's actually been chasing all the way around. He would have gotten that contained down to Pantheon.
He picked up like three health potions.
He did.
Along the way.
And the hook will not be landing on the Darius, but that's okay. You got the rest of your team actually pushing on up here into the top. Muffin Kitty backing off, grabbing a relic for himself. But Victor has recapped the 7 o'clock point. Pounce getting pretty damn low, and this is a four-man push here up top for Fear. They should be able to grab to 12 o'clock, and all of X-Orb, they are not prepared for this. They have not used their revives quite yet.
Oh, he just barely got the recall off. X-Smithy diving on top of him.
Very well
just
done.
At the last second, so that was really close. Call Me Pounce is able to get out of there, and Muffin Cutie, like Hayes, is trying to get the kill. He actually is very close to taking it down. It's not enough. He's going to get the stun. The Meditate is way too strong. He has another E, though. The Alpha Strike. Can he try and get out of there? He does actually go down, and then in the meantime, Katarina trying to pick up some kills in the top lane. Smithy, the Ignite, just not enough to take him down. The Spear grabs him, and they're able to pick up the kill.
Very impressive, and I'm waiting to see all the revives, but I'm not seeing it. Four members real quick here, the X-Orb retaking back 12 o'clock, and they have a very significant lead. On the game right here. Like, hey, it's actually gonna be grabbing the 5 o'clock straight after me. Just neutralizing it will be more than enough to get to even further the lead here on X-Orb. Kha'Zix leaping on out of trouble, recognizing Katarina. He knows he needs to get out. Gonna be going down, getting a little bit of slam action from Darius right in front of the 3 o'clock. Zuna getting very low. Katarina does eventually go down. There's the hook. Darius, he will not be popped up, though. Can he actually go down the turret? Going to be helping out on that one. Double kill for the Nidalee. Alistar got too close to that tower, too. Very well done. Fear actually making the best of the situation. There's a little bit of a misstep from X-Orb, but it's just a matter of what can you do with it.
Well, even when they're winning the fights, though, you see that Fear is falling further and further behind because X-Orb they're fighting at Fear's side. They're fighting, on the side turrets as opposed to the top one. They have complete control over the top one. The hook over the wall misses.
Nice.
Call Me Pounce. He's trying to chase down Mancloud for the kill. He's walking right into Shiprider, who's going to try to pick this up. The ultimate goes off. Mandatory Cloud does go down. Aphromoo's going to drop as well.
Nice.
And you see they still have a really great advantage. Their capture points, there is a little quest down here, so, first person to win is going to be in a great advantage. Muffin Cutie almost picking up Lycaeus, but Wild Turtle trying to help him out for a moment.
The minions, though, are doing work on the 7 o'clock, and never underestimate the minions here on Dominion. Nice, the death ray going to be more than enough, and that will leave plenty of time for Wild Turtle to actually recap 7 o'clock. Nidalee going to be going down over by 3. High and Pounce going to be grabbing that. Meanwhile, Kha'Zix Smithy is up on his own, going to be standing still, allowing the turret to hit him at 12. Just for a second, there is Katarina looking for damage. The Ignite still taking down on him. Something, anything. No! He was stealth, going to be able to get out of it.
He has another leap.
He's got one more leap. He's got the health relic, but can he escape? That's the problem here. You got the minions actually spotting him out. The hook not enough to reach, but High with a quick attack, going to take him out.
Yeah, so he does go down. And this is actually a good opportunity for them to push back in, but it's going to be tough. Darius is tanky enough that he should be able to defend this on his own. And it's still kind of a standoff in the bot lane, which is where all the pressure is. Pantheon actually ulting right on top of him. If they can force this, the hook back, just barely not hitting Nidalee. And High, he gets right into an Aphromoo hook as he lands. So they pick up that kill. Wild Turtle coming in, trying to help Pounce. Snowball, it's very close to him being able to dunk some people. Zuna doesn't actually go down. The exhaust was too much for him. Mandatory Cloud trying to pick up the kill. The headbutt back. The turret actually takes him down. Zuna very close as well. The hook actually almost killing Nidalee. He gets off the pulverize, but couldn't quite.
Oh,
it.
The headbutt's still enough, though, so that's plenty to take out Nid. Katarina looking for damage. Smithy getting very close. He's waiting for his opportunity. He wants his approach. Plenty of damage on the turtle. There's the Pulverize going to keep him knocked up. Still actually in the speed buff area. There's Shift Rider just waiting for his opportunity. Blitz the Commandant back, though. Afro Moo in this match. He wants, if he can get a hook right now in a cat, that would be ideal. Kha'Zix has the damage to take her out, but they still have a push they need to make here on 12 o'clock to get an advantage. Right now, though, X Orb, they've had a consistent 3 cap for the majority of this game. And the score shows, I mean, right now, Fear, their Nexus is already at half. And the plays that they've been making to try and come back have been absolutely minimal. They just cannot, they cannot get the pressure they want. The damage is just a bit much. And actually, now you see Victor actually roaming up to the top, looking for damage, and just they're looking to just seal the game.
Yeah, every single time that Fear is able to make a pushback, it's just inconsequential. Wild Turtle hooked in, but he pops his ultimate fairly easily. He misses the Pulverize, but trying to get the headbutt back out.
Oh,
and Victor's Kha'Zix swapped
nine.
Up. Oh, he's going to be able to take it. There's no one close enough. Darius is going to
actually
hit the
movement
speed.
The point may be neutralized, which would be still a mission success. But Pounce, though, does not get the hook. Smithy going to be wandering on a little wealth. Can he get the relic? No. There's the dunk in advance. And one quick swipe, making quick work of the bug.
Oh, Muffin Cutie's being pursued, though. I think he actually might be able to turn this around and pick up these kills, though, because Lee Sin's here as well. Mandatory Cloud is coming to help him out. Wild Turtle, he doesn't have his ultimate. They will go down very quickly. The kick, there's the kill. Muffin Cutie, he has the he doesn't actually get the reset on the Alpha Strike, but one more hit, he's going to be able to pick this up. Mandatory Cloud, with a wild Q, he completely misses there. The Pulverize trying to get him out of there. He does go down, but Shift Rider coming in, trying to pick this up. He doesn't quite get the kill. Mandatory Cloud's very close, though. Probably wants to back off. Muffin Cutie can try and help him out here.
But this has been a lot of time expended for Muffin Cutie and Mandatory Cloud here down bot. Meanwhile, you got like, hey, it's actually running amok there with a double on one Ray. Here in the top lane, going to be recapping 12 like it's no big thing. Who's getting low? Mandatory Cloud coming in. But you also got Xsmithie with the leap of faith here into the top. Is that that's a Guardian Angel actually on Pounce already? Wow.
Yeah, I almost thought that you couldn't buy GA on Dominion, but I guess you can.
Well,
I know you can get it on Twisted Treeline, or can.
Huh. Interesting. But it's weird. Like, you already have the revive. You might as well add another life onto it. And not to mention, this is a very offensive game. You're going to be in the middle of a lot of these fights. You might as well tank up. You might as well get that extra armor. And he's also building even more health. He's got that giant spell. He's got his Brutalizer. That's really all the damage he needs, I think, at this point.
Oh, the Garrison trying to help out Muffin Cutie. He hits the heal. He's actually close to turning this around. The Alpha Strike isn't quite enough. There's the kill.
Nice.
Hai is able to pick that up. We'll be able to try and take the base here. Wild Turtle coming around the side. His ultimate is back up, so he should be able to get out of here. His team's here as well. He needs to pop it. The Pulverize, he misses Xsmithie, who actually just barely gets over the other side. Pounce missing another hook, but they have complete control over the top. And so even though it's been kind of back and forth so far, Fear is just falling further and further behind.
Yeah.
X-Orb is significantly ahead. Xsmithie, the Hexstreaker pop. He tries to turn around, but he does go down. So Call Me Pounce is actually, they're going to get the revenge on him as well. But X-Orb,
full 5 cap.
The whole time that's going on,
cap.
Wow, they have it.
They have the they have the capture point ace now acquired for X-Orb. They got an all 5, and now the Nexus is quickly
They
being
just captured
by Fear.
That while the team was still there. They
Hell
were fighting,
yeah.
Trying to kill Darius, and they were just hanging out. They're like, yeah, we'll let you kill Darius. We're going to take your capture point.
But the quest is also still active on X-Orb. Also, like, hey, it's making some plays. He's looking for the stuns. There's the gate right in front of the... Nice spear from Nidalee Zuna just getting the end of that one.
Oh, they're very
the
close to losing, though. It's 4-1. They get to the top capture point, so that's huge.
The damage has already been done.
Down. They were like, 30 seconds away from losing that game, so that helps slow it down a lot, getting 2 capture points to try and turn it around.
Yeah, but they still need to neutralize one more point to still stand a chance. Katarina was looking to get that lightning buff, but Muffin Cutie going to be attempting to grab his. Just one more smack will interrupt him there. And already you got Darius and Alistar already back up to 12 o'clock looking to recapture that point. They still have an immense lead. And here's the big problem for Fear is that they cannot retake their 5 o'clock. They're having difficulty retaking the point closest to their spawn. And that's how you know you're in a really bad situation. You got the kill up top here. Down on to Blitz. Recapture at 12. You got the minions with support also. But still, though, I think this is just a matter of a few seconds. There's a minute clock. Fear has a minute clock to try and make a difference. And I'm not sure if it's going
to
happen.
Yeah, it needs to be a quick turnaround. Lycaeus is very close to going down, though. Mandatory Cloud trying to pick it up, but he has the backup from High L9.
Mandatory Cloud running from a cloud.
Going for it.
and also a very scary man in the sky hiding out in the bush. There's the Hexdrinker proc, and it's already gone. Quick kill down bot. 45 health left on Fear's Nexus.
And Xsmithy here, he's running away from Darius, but it's not really helping him at all. I mean, they're still losing. The longer he's running around, not, you know, really getting anything done, the more Xorb is going to be winning this match and turning it around. Muffy Cutie, he picks up the one kill. Is he going to get the does he get it? He doesn't have the refresh, but Heil 9, he's trying to take him down. He has enough speed, and he actually has enough heal. No mana on Pantheon, so he does good down. Darius picks up the kill into Nidalee and then trying to chase down Aphromoo. Yeah. But 30 seconds left. It's very close to them losing, and they aren't making any strong captures. Xsmithy, he's on the left side trying to get a capture for him.
Yeah, Hyde didn't even really need to be that aggressive over at 5 o'clock. They already had the game still distancing to sit back and defend. But Xsmithy with the sneaky cap down over at 9, leaping away just to get away from Cat. But the damage will be too much, and should be able to go down there to the ultimate popping. Waiting for Alistar. He's coming in just a second, but not necessarily needed. Recap, like, hey, it's going to be grabbing the 9. And this should, this is getting very close to the end. Minions actually a little OP here. Top lane Mandragora God helping a little bit on his own. Kicking Pounce to safety, allowing for that recap. Muffin Cutie almost going down. But Zuna still looking to be a pressure, looking to be a presence, cannot leap out of the way of the spears. Alpha Strike bringing Hyde very low, but stun backwards for the double. Three members of Fear are now dead. Aphromoo
gets
headbutted mid-grab. Shift Rider is actually still visible. It actually goes behind, goes backwards, and gets the kill on the Blitz.
It's
fantastic.
15 seconds left. They have to make a capture this really quickly because they're very close to losing. And it seems that Nick Allen is better than Red Baron. Might be really bad at Twisted Tree Line, but they're halfway decent at Dominion. They're taking a nice advantage over Fear. We saw Fear actually lost to Curse, I believe, in Dominion as well. But then they brought it home with the win on Proving Grounds.
Yeah.
But actually, Curse might have won that. I don't actually remember.
But either way, though, this means that the Decider will be on the Murder Bridge. 3-2, just give it another one. There's no way Fear can do anything here. That's zero counting down. Nexus goes down. It is 1-1 between Team Fear and Team Nick Allen's Baron Red Baron, the deciding match.